Okay, sorry for the delay. We should be live again. If anyone wants to bet, bets are open at dukeofthebomb.com/bet. Or if you just want to watch, that's cool too. So I was kind of planning on going for the Casanova achievement during a stream, but I ended up getting that one just kind of accidentally. That's where you get rescue 10 damsels in one game. And I just kind of did that naturally during one of my Yama runs. So I'm going to try to unlock the robot, which involves going to the alien mothership, which I don't think I've... Have I gone to the mothership during a stream? I'm not sure if I have. The alien mothership sucks. It is the worst level in the game, which is why I don't normally go there. But it'd be cool to show off, or it'd be cool to get the plasma rifle too. The plasma rifle is freaking awesome, and I've never actually gotten it. Getting the plasma rifle was a pain in the ass, though. I'm not sure if I'll be able to do it without dying. I like the mothership's Bippo. It's rough. The worm level is the worst level in the game. They're both pretty bad. I think I prefer the worm level over the mothership, though. Because at least in the worm level, the Chris Knife is relatively easy to get. All you have to do is bomb. Just throw a bomb in an acid pit and it's yours. Whereas to get the plasma rifle, you have to deal with the alien queen. That thing sucks. Let me know if the music's too loud, by the way. This is the Shadow of the Colossus soundtrack, which is one of my favorite soundtracks. And I haven't listened to it during a stream yet, so I thought I'd fire it up. CPC Gamer was right, though. That title music for Risk of Rain is really, really good. I wonder who did the music for that game, because it has pretty good music in general. Soundtrack to Shadow of the Colossus is just amazing. It adds to the feeling that you're entirely alone. Yeah, it is one of the most affecting soundtracks I've ever heard in a video game. Reminds me a lot of the Metroid soundtrack. The Metroid soundtrack was really good at making you feel alone too. For the NES. Volume sounds fine. Okay, good. Well, this is a quiet track too, so if when the music gets loud, if it overpowers my voice, let me know. Alright, see if I can do this. Yeah! Look what a badass I am. I shouldn't have tried to do that, because it's pretty risky. But, you know, now that I beat Yama, maybe I can, or beat Yama during a stream, I can afford to be a little riskier. Do some cool things. Oh, I forgot to sync up the chat again. Oh well. Fudge! Might be able to get that damsel and come back. Get an early sacrifice. Whip the powder box. You know, I actually did that once, just to make absolutely sure that it's not possible to whip it and get away from it before it blows up. It's not possible. If you survive it, you're a badass. Well, I'm not a badass, apparently. Oh, oops. Oh, I always do that. I forget that you can't walk past the door with a damsel if you want to sacrifice them. Oh well. Okay, we have the Ujet Eye on this level. Or the Wajet Eye, or whatever you want to call it. I'm not going to sacrifice the idol. So whoever always asks me to do that, don't bother asking. I have no interest in having a pooping monkey to follow around. I will take this damsel though. Compass, not bad. Not the best thing ever, but I'll take it. I always ask you to sacrifice the idol. Yeah, that's right, Pippo. Not going to happen. You know, you're right, you have a point. Maybe I will. No, I'm just kidding. Oh god, I knew that spider was up there somewhere. I didn't realize it was that close. Maybe I can make it jump on those spikes. Or maybe I can jump on the spikes. Oh, come on. You know you want to. Look at how inviting they are. Oh. Oh yeah, I have the spike boots. For a second I was wondering how I killed the spider so quickly. Ooh, bomb box. That might be worth throwing a couple spins of the wheel. Of course I'm going to get hit by that arrow trap. I have 11 ropes, so I'll be fine. Duke, you should try a game called EG. I've seen like screenshots and stuff of it. That's a Metroidvania, isn't it? The monkey is actually useful for some parts. It damages enemies when it's jumping. You can kill shopkeepers with them. Huh. I didn't know that. Oh, come on. Boo. Of course I win the prize, now that I have to avoid the ghost. I know this is a trap. This game's trying to get me to die to the ghost. Oh my god. That was close. Okay. Good deal. EG is a lot of fun and it has some phenomenal mechanics running in the background, but most of them go unmentioned. I would not call EG Metroidvania. Oh, that's what I heard. I might have been misinformed. Hey, black market right here. Nice. Aww. Those were my ropes, dog. Huh. Bees down there. I'm not gonna go for the health. It's not worth it. It's not worth the risk. Man, you really want my ropes, don't you? Yeah. I died to the ghost last daily because I accidentally grabbed a rope. I'm starting to hate ghosts more. Yeah, that's why I don't ghost mine. Like, I'll ghost mine if I have a vault and it's a relatively open level. Ooh, jetpack. But that's pretty much it. Oh, come on! Come on! Oh. Wow, Bippo bet $50 on my victory. Or $50. Sorry, Bippo. Died to the shopkeeper. I didn't think that bomb would set him off. But apparently it did. Don't know if I asked you before, Duke, but do you like FTL? I haven't played it. I have a feeling I won't like it, though. Oops. Meant to do the daily. Let's go ahead and do that. Daily challenge hype, everyone. I don't need more practice rounds. I beat Yama during a stream. I'm a badass. Badasses don't need to practice. I mean, I had one practice round, which, you know, should be plenty. Wow, this level seems kind of bare. And not in a good way. I mean, bare of gold and gems. Yeah, FTL, I don't know. It seems like it's not an RTS, but it looks like it shares the same DNA as an RTS. Like, I don't like having to manage a bunch of things at the same time. I'm no good at those kinds of games. I mean, I have it. It was in one of the Humble Bundles, so I will probably try it someday, but I'm not planning on it anytime soon. Man, 5400, shitty level. Really shitty level. You can pause the combat, though. Oh, can you? I didn't know that. Oh, by the way, hi, the GTF. But I mean, even in games where you can pause the combat, like, I was really bad at Dragon Age, and with that, that has, like, the old Baldur's Gate-style combat, where, you know, you have to control several characters, but you can pause the combat, and I was still really bad at that game. Like, I didn't understand anything about the strategy in Dragon Age. So, I don't know. I mean, it depends on the game, really, I guess. It's more of a turn-based strategy game because you should always pause the game, give orders, and then resume. Yeah, I tried that with Dragon Age, and I don't know, it didn't work. Of course, I'm not really that good at turn-based strategy either. This is the first Colossus you meet in Shadow of the Colossus. Really excellent, excellent track. Aw, man. I'm gonna have to rob the shopkeeper, aren't I? I mean, look at this. This is just too inviting to pass up. Alright. I'm not gonna do the jetpack, because last time that got me killed. Oh, crap. I forgot I still had sticky bombs. Oh, thank God. Okay. I thought that first one would set him off for sure. Well, I could go, well, I don't have the Ujjarai yet. Oh no, this is the first Colossus fight. I think the last track was just leading up to the first Colossus. So, still have time to get your bets in. I would recommend betting on Shopkeeper. Because they're going to be pissed off this whole game. Alright, time to stop dicking around. Why do the daily challenges always have dark levels? Murphy's Law. Where do you bet? DukeOfTheBump.com/bet. Or just go to DukeOfTheBump.com and there's a link to Spelunky Death Roulette. I don't know if that's easier though. Easier than typing a slash bet. Thank you, Kasha. Yeah, I mean, I probably shouldn't answer that question because of the stream delay. By the time I do, someone will have always answered it in the chat room. So thank you. Oh my god. Oh Jesus, that was so close. Was not expecting a shopkeeper that far up. Aw man. I'm gonna have to use like 3 bombs to get that key. That sucks. No other way in. Well, I guess I could come in from the bottom. Damn it. I was probably too close to that wall to get the double bomb trick to work. Oh man, this is bad. This is really bad. Sorry, dog. I mean, I guess since I'm just doing a mothership run, I don't actually need the Ankh and stuff. Since I don't need to go to hell to unlock the robot. But I mean, it'd be nice to turn this into another Yama kill. That'd be fun. Oh, that thing's already been triggered. Okay. Well, this is the daily, so I guess I shouldn't even worry about the robot in this one. I'll save that for next time. I mean, it could be pretty awesome getting the, well, you can unlock characters during the daily. I forgot about that. So yeah, no robot for me. Ah, crap. I should go. Okay. I let my cat walk on my keyboard unintentionally, says Bibbo. Well, that's what cats are for. I don't know, it could still be cool to get the plasma rifle during a daily. You wouldn't be able to do anything crazy like take it to the City of Gold. But you could, mess up Olmec's lair pretty well. But nah, I'm not going for it. Crap. Wonder if there's going to be anything in that shop worth getting. Not a present, but I already had the jetpack, so it's not really worth risking anything for. Yeah, I don't know. I should try FTL. I should try more games outside of my comfort zone. Aw, man. There's an altar there. I could get the Kapala, like, in this level. If that shopkeeper doesn't kill me. Well, I might be able to get the Kapala this level. Okay. There's 2 shopkeepers running around. I should stop pressing my luck, actually. Just get out of here. Plasma rifle is fantastic if you can get to hell on a run. That's how I got my 1.4 million on that one daily. Jesus Christ, 1.4 million. That's insane. That's... I will probably never get that much money in a single run. probably lost out on a lot of money in that last level. But, I mean, the mines are the most dangerous area to encounter a shopkeeper. I guess I should lock the bets. Oh wow, there's quite a few bets this time. Nice. The victorious music. Very nice. Shadow of the Colossus is one of the few games that has, like, dynamically changing music, depending on how you're actually doing in the game. Phantasy Star 3 also did that. But I can't think of many games with that feature, other than those two. Oh man, it's an old bitey level. There's a lot of money up for grabs if you can actually go down there and kill the piranhas and kill old bitey. Hey, there's a lot of chests down there. Of course, having a shopkeeper running around is not going to make it any easier. I've never actually killed old bitey before. That's the big fish, by the way. His name is old bitey. I should probably not. I mean, I'm all for taking more dumb risks now, but not during a daily. I mean, maybe the shopkeeper will just kill everything for me. That'd be nice. Oh, he's doing some pretty significant damage there. Of course, then I have a shopkeeper to deal with. Looks like he's stuck. Oh no, there it goes. Oh my god. I should stop messing around with this. I'd really like all that money though. Old bitey isn't tough once you weed out the piranhas. It just requires patience. Yeah, that's true, but there was a very volatile shopkeeper down there. You know, it's better to live longer and make it to Olmec, I think. I mean, for me, since I'm not doing any like ghost mining or anything crazy like that. I will get that vault though. Probably going to have to use quite a few bombs to do this. Oh, that didn't get him. I could have ghosted that stuff, but nah. I think ghosting is just boring to watch. No spike shoes, unfortunately. Ah. Alright, there's a shopkeeper over here somewhere. Oh wait, he might be dead. Oh! He was not dead already. The shotgun lay on the ground. Gave me a false confidence. Alright, well, congratulations Bippo, the GTF, and Tarka. I think I've died to the shopkeeper more during Death Roulette than anything else. I mean, that's just the best thing to bet on. Alright, well, now that I don't have the daily challenge to worry about, I can go for the robot. Hey, a number 4. That's not going to last long. I always say that. It's always true. I'm probably number 4 out of like 10. I don't know. No? Well, most of these people, I'm sure, are still doing it. Glad they fixed the leaderboards. You can actually scroll through the dailies, and they're in the right order now. So you can actually go 17, 18, 19, 20, and see all of them. That was a pretty good run. Almost 200k. I mean, it wasn't great, but it's better than... That was a good run. 317k. All my money on success again. Well, if you insist, Bippo. Alright, let's do a couple more runs. See if I can get that robot. I guess I should bring Meat Boy out, now that I actually unlocked him. Yep, just one more to unlock. Most of these characters I've never even played. Don't get killed by a tiny spider, please. I'll try not to. I'll tell you what, though, I almost guarantee it's going to be a shopkeeper. Call it a hunch. I wonder why Meat Boy is the only character that's like based off of another game. At least I think so. None of the other characters seem familiar. In Super Meat Boy the game, there's a ton of characters that are like cameos from other indie games. I mean, it just seems kind of weird that the game has 16 characters and only one of them is a cameo. Or 16 unlockable characters, I should say. The Cyclops is one too. Oh, what's the Cyclops from? I've heard people say that playing the Cyclops angers shopkeepers. Really? That's weird. Oh, hired hand shopkeepers. Is it because the Cyclops is one of the possible hired hands? It seems kind of weird if that's the case. All the indie guys are actual friends and super cool with this kind of thing. Yeah, that's the impression that I got. I mean, not all of them, obviously, but there is a pretty big community. Man, I would love to steal both of these bomb boxes and the gloves, but I'm just gonna buy one of the bomb boxes for now. I might be back later. Oh, crap. Maybe I should have bought the gloves instead of a bomb box. I don't know. That's always a tough decision if you can only get one of them. I'm not going to have enough money to buy anything else. Oh well. I can see Isaac or Gomez being in this. Oh, Gomez from Fez, yeah. That would be pretty cool. Or Isaac. I don't know. Isaac strikes me as not nearly maneuverable enough for this game. I mean, I know that doesn't matter, but like, just in character canon. I mean, I guess Isaac is a spelunker. Like, literally. Because one of the levels in Binding of Isaac is the caves, so... I guess it would be a good fit. Who is Gomez? He's the dude in the Fez from the game Fez. Another game I haven't played yet. That I own. I did one of those Steam calculator things that shows the percentage of games you own that you've actually played, and it was pretty embarrassing. I think I've only played, like, not even beat, played, like 20% of the games that I own. I don't know, maybe it wasn't that low, but it was pretty close. Phew, I should not have tried that, but it worked out for me. I should have just dug and gone down. Oh well. I was actually wondering if I could survive that or not, so that was a good experiment. Ow. I missed the rain risking. Yeah, I called it quits in Risk of Rain after about an hour and a half. Aw, fudge. I don't know. It's an okay game, but I don't know if it's for me. F you, buddy. I've played every game I own on Steam, but with that said, it's only like 3 games. Yeah, and to be fair, a lot of the games I haven't played are bundle games that I did not pay a lot of money for. And everything else I bought on sale. You're not a real gamer unless you have 100 games on Steam you've never played. Boy, ain't it the truth. What are you, CPC gamer? Casual? LOL. Ugh. I hate people like that. You know, I'm a casual gamer. I'll admit it. I play a lot of video games, but I'm not hardcore into any of them. Well, except Spelunky, I guess. But even, Fudge. I mean, even with Spelunky, you know, compared to the super professional gamers, I'm still casual. And who cares? It's dumb to worry about a label like that. People who throw that label around like it's something to be ashamed of suck. Ah, crap. Yeah, I'd say Duke is quite a Spelunky fanatic. Yeah, I think I've officially put more time into Spelunky than any other game in my Steam library. Like, I think I just barely edged out Binding of Isaac. Oh! Oh my god! Alright, who bet on Giant B? I was hoping I could get it stuck on that, on the worm tongue, and then I could just bomb it to death. No bets for the bee. Sorry, everyone. Where is the bee? Oh, there he is. Or there she is, I should say, since it's the queen bee. It amuses me the idea of having a life outside of your games is now used as a pejorative. Yeah, exactly. You know, sometimes I'll just take a break from video games. I just won't play anything for like a month, and I'll do other shit. I died on 1-2 on the daily because fuck giant spiders on dark levels. I agree. CBC casual is more like it. Yeah. Alright, let's go again. I'm not gonna go too much later. I mean, I know you guys like the long streams, but I would like to eat dinner at some point. I haven't eaten any. Well, I had a cup of yogurt and a banana, and that was my post-work snack. But other than that, I haven't had anything since lunch. It was a very potassium-rich snack. That's why I have so much energy tonight. My potassium levels are sky high. Hope I didn't OD. I don't know what the LD50 is for potassium, but hopefully it's more than one banana and one cup of yogurt. I joke, but I actually know someone who once commented on my banana and yogurt eating and said that I was getting too much potassium. And I was like, gee, I don't think a little yogurt and a couple bananas is going to push me over the limit for the day. I think they might have been joking though. Be fair, I'm not 100% sure. Oh, did I forget to start a new round? Oh, sorry about that. Bets are open. I'll go until, I'll leave the bets open until 2-2 to make up for the level you didn't get to bet. Unless I forget to lock them again, which is quite possible. Looks like I can come in from below. So I can just use a rope instead of a bomb there. You have to get sticky bombs if you want to kill Yama. Well, you can kill him with a shotgun. But yeah, I mean, I wouldn't want to get to Yama without sticky bombs. Yeah, Kasha was asking me the other day how you're supposed to kill Yama if you don't have sticky bombs or a shotgun. And I was like, I don't think you do. Wow, lots of bombs. Nice. Should be able to buy all of them. And I don't have to buy the paste now. Shoddy and well-placed rope can do the job. Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to say Yama's impossible if you don't have the shotgun or bombs, because I'm sure someone's whipped him to death, but I would not want to try. Oh, you can cook the fuses on the bombs, too. That's a good point. Unfortunately, you have to be standing to do that. You can't do that while you're hanging from a rope. So that would be a pretty risky proposition. Chat, can you kill Yama with a whip and no ropes? Glue is like the second best item next to the jetpack. Yeah, I agree. It's not worth attempting dailies without going for killing giant spiders. Yeah, I've definitely had runs where I was screwed because I never got the paste. No bombs is less of an issue because of Oxhead and Horseface. Each are worth boxes. Yeah, that's true. As long as you have a way to kill them, then you have bombs in hell. I forgot about that. Giant spiders are stupendously erratic. True. You can kill Yama without bombs and a shotgun if you bring the eggplant. Yeah, all you have to do is bring the eggplant. It's not that hard, guys. Aw, man, should I go for the mystery box? I think I should. I think I got ripped off. Oh well. Let's see, which of these three items is most important? I'm gonna go with the mitt. I might come back for the other two. if I get more money. You don't need paste if you bring the alien blaster. Yeah, that's true. Aw, bummer. Well, trade 2 bombs for 3. It's a net gain, I guess. Ah, fudge. Should've just bombed the giant spider to begin with. Oh well. I tried to be elite. That's what I get. I'm still kind of in daily challenge mode. So I'm like, man, should I go for their gems or not? And I was like, fuck that. Hired hands are basically express tickets to death. Yeah, if I get a hired hand accidentally, like in the black market or something, I'll kill them as soon as possible. I think most people do. I've seen a hired hand with the alien blaster shoot at nothing to hit a wall at point blank range. Yeah, the only thing hired hands are actually good for is carrying the scepter if you're trying to do an eggplant run, or bring the plasma cannon into the City of Gold. They're good for that. I mean, it's still extremely risky and dangerous, but they make that actually possible. And they're good for sacrificing at altars. Those are the only two reasons to ever use the hired hand for anything. I'm back here, you. Aw, oh, man. Bummer. It'd be nice if there was an altar on this level, because I could get the hired hand and immediately get the Kapala. But does not look like it. Alright. Wasting too much time. I could go to the worm. I haven't really shown off the worm before. Supposedly, it's possible to go to the worm on a hell run if you do it in the ice caves. Because if you go to the worm and the alien mothership, supposedly it's still possible to get the Moai head. I'm not really sure how it works, since I've never seen anyone do it. I mean, I could try that. It would be pretty dumb, and I doubt I'd succeed. Shit, just sacrificed the idol for the monkey and immediately killed it on accident. Yeah, that's why I never go for the monkey. Well, one of the many reasons. The main reason being, that's a freaking monkey that poops gold. That didn't work out. It spawns another level after 3-4, and the head is on that level. Oh. I did not know that. The gold monkey is worth it. I mean, if you don't mind... Ah! Spending that much time following the monkey around. Which, you know, personally, I do. Tiki Trap. Congratulations, Kostya, Tarka, the GTF. Congrats to all three of you. Alright, new round. I meant to drop down, drop a bomb, and then immediately jump, but my thumbs were not fast enough, apparently. Oh, are you that far behind, Bippo? Jeez. They don't poop enough money for how much it costs to get one. I mean, I think technically they poop a little bit more money than the idol's worth. But, I mean, it's not worth keeping the monkey alive and following it around and, you know, touching money that came out of a monkey's butt. Alright, see you later, CPC Gamer. Thanks for hanging out. I appreciate you. I mean, I know it's like almost 1 a.m. there, so. It's, very, very nice of you to stick around. If you're ghost mining the idol, monkey is super worth it. Just carry it with you. Well, yeah, that's true, but then you can't carry around, you know, a matic or a shotgun or whatever item you have. I'm watching the stream on my PC as well as my laptop. Oh. Huh. How come? That seems weird. And buy some bombs. And buy some spike shoes. Aw, man. I have no idea where the chest is. Oh, I should have just pushed that block and then jumped over. And grabbed the key. Oh well. I've had a nap in the evening, so I'm up for a long stream. Oh, cool. Oh, there it is. That wasn't too bad. My PC is running the stream just fine. My laptop is just crappy. Man, is this worth using the rest of my ropes to get the sacrifice? Yeah, I think it is. Would have been nice if that was climbing gloves, but oh well. You can't always get what you want. But sometimes you get what you need. That does not apply to me in this case. Oh, okay, gotcha. I don't know why I did that. I was not thinking clearly. Dang, wish this was a score run. Look at all this crap. Okay, it looks like I might get the Kapala. Oh, I don't know. I might not be able to get that damsel now that I used all my ropes. You have ropes for sale? No, but you have climbing. Well, I can get up here. Woohoo! Blood for the Blood Goddess. Kind of appropriate music for making a sacrifice to the Blood Goddess. I'd buy those spring shoes if I had a couple more thou. Do you like that? My relationship with thousands of units of currency is so casual that I had to make a nickname for it. No, just a few hundo. And I think that's enough for the springs. Nope, 200 more. Damn. Well, maybe I can just get some gold. Yep, there we go. Alright, I'm out. Well, that did not work as planned. I meant to activate the cape and float down to them, but... oh well. I'm a minin. Did the original Spelunky have a Matic? I don't think it did. It's kind of crazy since it's like a really important addition in competitive Spelunky play. Or maybe it did. I don't know. It's been a long time since I played non-HD Spelunky. I remember it had like a bow and arrow item that I almost never found. And it was really weird. Oh, it did have a Matic. That was before I really understood. Oops. Oh well. Really understood how good the Matic is. I think. Alright, I'm out. Lock in the bets, lock in the bets. Cost you betting on the Alien Queen? I think that's kind of a long shot, but might pay off for you. Aw, man. I hate it when I have an item in a dark level and I have to set it down so I can carry the torch. It's a real bummer. And I still have no ropes. Wonder if there's way I can climb up there. Doesn't look like it. That sucks. I was going to sell this idol and then buy the rest of that stuff. Maybe I shouldn't have used all my ropes to get that sacrifice. I saw a ding somewhere in this general vicinity. Alien queen bet is tits. Is that good or bad? Oh, there it is. Yeah, I didn't have time to switch back to the slaw, unfortunately. Because I do enjoy the slaw. Even though I know some people in the stream aren't a fan. Tits is good unless you don't like tits, I guess. Yeah, that's how I heard. That's how I've heard the term used, but I don't know if that's actually a good bet. I don't know. I guess we'll see. I wonder if that's worse than dog juicing. Of course it is. It's a human being. It's way worse with a human. Unless you're some kind of PETA animal hugger, I guess. Alright, have to be careful with this one. Because this is what messed me up last time. Was bombing too close to the shop. Alright, should be in good shape. Oh, I should have bought the sticky bombs first. I could have taken out that shopkeeper immediately. Oh well. Well, I didn't have enough to buy them, since I spend the rest of my money on a kiss. Pug greater than sloth, obviously. Yeah, that's how Bippo feels as well. I don't know if I can agree with that. Nice. I have a feeling that I'm breathing into this mic way too much, because this is a new mic and I don't have a windscreen for it yet. Since the windscreen from my old mic doesn't fit. I've been meaning to get one, I just haven't bothered yet. So I hope the breathing is not too distracting. Wow, no ropes in this entire black market? That's not good. The one time I actually want ropes. It doesn't have any. How do you pronounce Doge? Doge. That's how I pronounce it anyway. Picking up money for no reason, because I'm dumb. You like sloth, I like pug. Let's make a compromise and choose slug. Yeah, someone make a mod for this game so that the three damsels are sloth, pug, and slug. I would enjoy that. Of course, you'd have to do the slug art yourself, but I'm sure there's a talented artist out there somewhere willing to do that. Duke's pronunciation is wrong, but correct. It's quite a paradox. No, it's a reference to an old Homestar Runner episode. Homestar Runner refers to someone as a D-O-G-E. And I think he was trying to to make it sound like dog-e. D-O-G-E. But Strong Bad interpreted it as Doge. That's where that originated. And then some people use that for a meme. And a spider web. That's what caused me problems. I want to just run straight to the exit, but if I get stuck, I'm probably dead. Phew! It's supposed to be doggy, but the troll way is the right way. Right. The troll way. I didn't realize that was the troll way. Wait, does that make me a troll? I don't want to be a troll. Are you sure that's the troll way? I thought it was just the funny way. If saying Doge makes me a troll, then I withdraw my pronunciation. At least I have plenty of bombs. That's one thing I can't complain about on this run. I see Just Drop is playing Spelunky at the moment. Hope he has better luck with the daily than I did. But you know, now that I beat Yama during a stream, I have to start taking more risks, try to become more elite. Trolling sometimes is funny. I don't know. See, a lot of people use the word troll incorrectly. Like, if someone makes a joke, they'll call that trolling. But to me, trolling is just being a dick, and I don't want to be a dick. I'm terrible at this game, so probably not, says Just Drop. Well, I was terrible at this game for a long time, too. If you're doing something wrong intentionally, how is that not being a troll? Trolling is being a jerk trying to get a reaction out of someone. Doing something wrong intentionally isn't automatically trolling. Oops, sorry, dog. Unless the reason you're doing it is to piss people off. In which case, I guess that's trolling. But if someone gets pissed off because you mispronounce a word, then maybe that person deserves to be trolled. Well, I can still go to the worm if I want, since it works with a dead dog. Or a dead damsel. Being a dick is sometimes funny as well. Nah, I'm gonna have to disagree with you there. Do you think Metroid's hand is a gun, or is it an attachment? That is quintessential troll. I mean, if someone gets riled up by that, then I don't know what to tell you. Screw it. Let's go to the worm. Why the heck not? Wait, did I lock the bets? I forget if I did or not. Yeah, I did. Okay. Alright, so I'm going to want to set it up so I can bring the shotgun with me. That'll make the worm a lot easier to deal with. I mean, I've only shown off the worm like once, so might as well. Why the effing bleep not? Galen linked to the Strombad Doge in the chat room if anyone wants to check that out. Alright, the worm is a lot harder when you go to it in the ice caves, because you have ice cave enemies to deal with. Mostly just the UFOs is the tough part. But hey, Meepo is in his natural environment, so it should be okay. I have to remember, I have twice as much time in this level. So, no need to rush. I wonder if the shotgun can kill those things, the spike balls. I don't think I've ever actually made it to the one with the shotgun, so I don't know if it can or not. Doesn't look like it. Nope. Of course, I had the Kapala, so I could sit here and just juice those things. Get a ton of gold out of a ton of blood out of them. It'd take a while, though. Okay, if someone is so... I don't even know what the word is. So sensitive that they get mad at you for using the wrong term or the wrong word or something. And okay, that kind of trolling, I can see, being worthwhile. The fuck killed me? Can I bring the replay of that up? It's probably too late now. What the fuck just killed me? This isn't gonna load. Oh, there it goes. Okay. Oh well, I can still go to the mothership. That's the whole reason for me doing this. So, do you guys know what just happened? Because I do not. You saw that coming, Pinful Dwarf. What the fuck happened? The block respawning crushes you. Oh. Okay. Well, I need a break after that. BRB. I forgot about the blocks. Oh well. Still in the game. Of course, I lost my my cape and my shotgun. It's kind of a drag. Man, the worm level is not a good level to respawn on. I can still get the Chris knife. Oh, is that block right there? Okay. I need to stop being so damn stingy with my bombs. Woo! Oh, can't kill Yama with it, but it's fun to have. Man, losing my cape. That sucks. Maybe I'd be better off just dropping the shotgun. Because the Chris knife can actually hit these things. Or kill them, rather. Does bombing those blocks permanently get rid of them? No, I guess not. I think I've discovered that on stream before. I just forgot about it. Was that the end of this? I thought the soundtrack was longer. Oh well. We can listen to it again. Start over from the beginning, please. No? Don't want to? I guess that was the whole thing. Oh well. There we go. Okay. How much time do I have? Plenty of time. Oh god. Oh my god, that was so risky. Just trying to drop on the shopkeeper's head. Hold on. Alright, congratulations Kostya, the GTF, and Tarka. Once again, the shopkeeper proves to be the wise bet. Alright, I'm gonna do one more, and then I'm gonna eat some dinner. Just Rep died to the giant spider in 1-2. That sucks. See, I'm not used to going to the worm level, so I kind of forgot that there would be a shopkeeper there. I mean, it makes sense, since there's a shopkeeper at the end of every level. I just sacrificed a live shopkeeper for the first time ever. Wow. How many points is that worth? It seems very difficult to pull off. Couldn't stop myself. Did I start bets again? Yeah, I did. Okay. Bets are open. DukeOfTheBump.com/bet if anyone is wondering how to play Death Roulette. Oh, I didn't update my status on Twitch. So no one actually knows that I'm playing Death Roulette. And random passersby still think I'm playing Risk of Rain. Oh well. A live shopkeeper is worth 6 points. That's pretty good. I wouldn't say it's a very wise bet. With so many people betting on it, you barely win anything. Yeah, but it's better to win a little bit of money than to lose money, is my philosophy. No, any gain is better than a loss. As business types will be able to tell you. CEOs and MBAs and all that. should be able to get that cape now. I believe 13,000 is enough this early on. Yep, more than enough. Fudge. Alive damsel is worth 8 points. Oh, so alive shopkeeper isn't even worth as much as a damsel? Nah, that's not as good as I thought. For some reason, I thought alive damsel was 4. I should have just brought up Kohina.com. That way I wouldn't have had to repeat the music. Oh well, the soundtrack's good enough to repeat, I think. My laptop stream just now caught up to the point where you died. Wow. That is a pretty bad laptop. What is that, like a... what's an old laptop brand? Adele Inspiron, or Inspiron, or however you pronounce it. Or what about a ThinkPad? Do they still make those? I think they still make the ThinkPad, but it's IBM now, or it's Lenovo now instead of IBM. The Sony Vaio, they don't make that, right? Pretty sure they closed their Vaio brand. Shut it down. It's an Acer Aspire 1. Oh, the netbook? That's what I have. It is pretty crappy, but the only reason I have it is, to, like, check email and do web browsing and stuff. Like, I've never tried to watch a stream on it. It does not handle Flash very well, though, so I can see it not working well with Twitch. It's not just an old laptop, it's a bad laptop. It was bad when it was new, but it's cheap, which was all I cared about at the time. It was like $200. And you know, for just general internetery, it does a fine job. I bet you can still play Heroes 3 on it. What's Heroes 3? Is it Heroes of Might and Magic? Probably, since they're up to like 6 now, right? I could barely run Dungeons of Dreadmore. I think Dungeons of Dreadmore just always runs bad. Because that game does not run well on my desktop. Like, I don't have the best computer ever. But, like, I cannot run Dungeons of Dreadmore in 1080p without, like, an unbearable amount of slowdown. I think that game's just not very well optimized. Yes, Duke, it is Heroes of Might and Magic. And you guys and your Might and Magic. Apparently I need to play this series. Dungeons of Dreadmore runs great for me. Yeah, but your monitor is only like 1280 by, or your monitor is not 1080p, so that's probably why. Like, I could probably run it okay in a smaller window. It runs for me, but I was terrible at it. Always died once I hit the second floor. Yeah, I was really bad at that game, too. I don't think I really got that game. Which sucks, because it was a, like, traditional, you know, non-action roguelike. And I do enjoy those. But Dungeons of Dremor wasn't my cup of tea. Or coffee. Speaking of coffee, did you guys know that there's going to be a coffee shortage? Like, there was a serious drought in the part of Brazil that grows most of the coffee beans that we use, the Arabica beans. And they're expecting the price of coffee to go up pretty significantly. Not anytime soon, since they still have, like, a large supply of beans from previous harvests. But, like, coffee is going to become scarce for a while, probably. Alright, I doubt the black market is here. So, hope you guys can get used to drinking tea. I mean, I love both tea and coffee, but when you want a cup of coffee, tea is not really a good substitute. Duke, if you play Heroes of Might and Magic, you should try the third one. The other ones are controversial. Some people like them, some don't. But everyone likes three? I like that I could play a woman in the DLC. Oh, in Dungeons of Dreadmoor? I thought the game always let you create a female character. Because I'm pretty sure I played as one usually. It was one of those blank slate type characters. Okay, Bippo. If it makes you happy, I'll sacrifice the idol. I mean, since they're right next to each other and everything. But you owe me one, man. Actually, I owe you one, since you just gave me a free game. But that is the much talked about pooping monkey. I hope it was worth it. I should sacrifice the damsel, the dogsel. I think it would be worth going back up there. Still haven't found the black market, surprisingly. Aw, man, that boomerang guy. Well, I should be okay. I can just avoid him. So wait, what happens if you sacrifice the monkey? Does it give you an idol back? Oh, you can't. Oh. Oh, the monkey is apparently not very durable. Sorry, Bippo. I didn't mean to get your hopes up and then kill the monkey. Now kill it and drink its blood. Way ahead of you. Actually, way behind you. Well, still no black market. I was going to say, still no BM, but that's not true, is it? Lol. Alright, one more level, so the black market has to be here. Oh, there it is. Again, I mean, it's not super important that I go to the black market in this run, but it'd be nice. Oh, there it is. I see it. It's right there. Dungeons of Dreadmore is a great game if you're into eyebrows. You know, in the local mall here, there's a store, well, I guess it's not a store, it's like a salon, dedicated just to eyebrows, at least I assume, because the name of the store, or the salon, is Beautiful Brows. So apparently some people really are into eyebrows. I mean, maybe they do just general hair there as well. I just think it's a funny name for a salon. Beautiful Brows. I also love them Diggles. Yeah, Diggles are awesome. It's the best thing about Dungeons of Dreadmore. I went to buy a Diggle plushie. Do they make those? That would be pretty adorable. Go away, you. Have the guys who made Dungeons of Dreadmore done anything else? Or is that their only game? Because, I mean, I'd be interested in seeing what else they make. Nope. Oh, okay. I thought I was about to get ranged. Let's do this the safe way. Aw, man. I knew that was going to happen. That always happens. No. Okay. Jetpack in the mystery box. Is it safe? I don't think so. I'm sure that guy's lying in wait. No? Where'd he go? Oh, he fell. Okay. Alright, how much time do I have? About 45 seconds or so. Oh my god. Shopkeeper. Bonanza. Oh no, not the Skelly. Oh, okay, that worked. That was almost a disaster. Nope. Okay. Aw, man, those corpses. Oh no. Did I get him? Okay. Thank God. Okay. Gotta get the hell out of here. But I can't panic. If I panic, I'm dead. Alright, let's do the safe strats. And get that ghost well out of the way. The group Gaslamp Games are currently working on Clockwork Empires. Oh, I do like games about clocks. Like Zyborn Clock. That one's pretty good. Oh no. They've been working on this game for quite a while. Oh, that's cool. It's definitely... It'll definitely be on my radar. Hope it feels better than Dungeons of Dreadmoor did. Yeah, let's go ahead and get a sacrifice. So hopefully, later on I can get the invigoration. Getting the invigoration, I think, was key in getting my Yama win on stream. Because having a lot of health was definitely important. And I didn't really have a chance to mummy farm in that run. So, the invigoration can be a game changer. So many good games, so little time. Yeah, that's always a problem. Alright, well, if I'm going to do a mothership run, I'm well equipped for it. Because I have a shotgun and I have 40 bombs, 13 ropes, and a Kapala. I'd really like to get the plasma rifle. That'd be so cool. I haven't been extremely lucky enough to just find one randomly in a crate yet. I need to look up what the actual odds for that are. Because I would have thought I would have found at least one by now. Come on, aggro. Thank you. Man, I wish this music was playing when I killed Yama. That would have been perfect. This is like the ultimate victory music. So satisfying. Oh, Shaku Crew is already dead. That's kind of. Not that it matters, since this is the Moe level. Alright, let's get some health before I leave. Before I make my glorious exit. Sorry, I'm just enjoying this music. Gives you a warm, fuzzy feeling. I don't understand why my climbing gloves failed there. Maybe I guess I wasn't close enough to the wall. Oh, missed him. Damn it. It's the best way to take those aliens out. And I got replacements. Nice. Alright, anything else I should look for here before I head to the mothership? I mean, it would be nice for me to get another shotgun. But the shopkeeper's probably just going, oh no. I just want to say he'll probably just fall off the edge, but there's no real edge here. If I can tag him with a bomb, it's probably not going to happen, though. Oh well. Worth a shot. Sorry, lady. Alright. Alien mothership time. Duke, have you played XCOM? Nope. It's on my list. Another one of those games that's going to be outside of my comfort zone. Oh my god, the alien mothership is so scary. I really hate it, guys. Like, I really do not like this level at all. But, you know, sometimes you have to go to scary places to get ahead. I mean, it'll be worth it because the robot is by far the best character. I mean, once I unlock the robot, that's who I want to be every time. Do these blue lights actually do anything? Like, I always see people break them in streams. But I don't know if they actually do anything or not. Oh my god. Oh my god. Powerful psychic blast has liquefied my brains. Oh wait. I never lost the bets, damn. Alright, so what does that count as? I guess that counts as... Was that an alien lord? Yeah, I guess it was. Because the alien queen does a weird lock-on thing. That's really terrifying. Yeah, I was checking just to make sure there's no specific psychic blast thing, but I guess that would just be the alien lore. Alright, sorry everyone. At least I made it to the mothership. For however briefly. Alright, well, it was a lot of fun. Thanks everyone for hanging out. Thanks to any new people who stopped by. Damn, I dropped below the starting 500. I have 15, and I've had to replenish my supply like a couple times. You should cheat, use a shortcut. I mean, I could. I don't know. I think all the only thing that using shortcuts does is it deprives you of the resources you get on the earlier levels. I mean, if I just used a shortcut and went straight to the ice caves, I'd have 4 bombs and 4 ropes and nothing. So I think my survivability would be a lot lower. Oh, something to think about, I guess. Thanks to everyone. You know, you guys make this awesome. It's a lot of fun. And hope to see you guys soon. Goodbye.